Hey guys, Fugus 101 here, and I'm back. Been gone for a long time. I'm really sorry, guys. It really makes me angry that I haven't uploaded a video in like 3 weeks. But I just recently started school, and I've been very busy. And good news, I am almost finished with my Bane drawing. It turned out really good, in my opinion. So expect a video of that maybe this weekend or later on next week. But anyway, today I'm going to be doing my review on the movie The Possession, which I just got back from seeing. It's another demon movie. And in my opinion, it was pretty good. It's not the most original idea for a movie, but it was a good time. It was an hour and a half, and I went with like 10 of my friends to see it, and it was just a really fun time. So basically, the main plot of the movie is you have a dad, or parents, and they have two daughters, and the parents just got divorced, so they're going to their dad's house. And my friend Andrew and I got to the movie a little late, so we walked in maybe 5 minutes of the movie had already gone by. But when I came in, the dad just picked up the girls from their moms, and he's driving them back, I guess, to his house. And they stop at like a yard sale, I guess. And they find this, they get this box. This girl, she gets this box. And there's like all this crap inside of it. There's like a ring. There's just a bunch of weird stuff inside. And throughout the movie, the girl is gradually getting more obsessed with the box. And she's showing really weird signs. Like, she just keeps asking, like, "Where's my box? Don't touch my box. No one can touch my box except me. Don't even look at it. Don't even go near it." So the dad's like, "All right, it's kind of weird." Then she starts to show signs that she's not herself. So she starts to hear voices from the box. She begins talking to it. She tells her dad, like, I talked to my friend that's in the box, which is kind of a cliche thing in possession movies like that. They say, like, "Oh, she's my friend," or my like, the demon is their friend. They refer to it as their friend, so that's kind of a cliche. But her voice changes, too. Like, sometimes she'll be talking like a little girl. She's, like, 10 years old. Other times, her voice will get lower and gruff, and it's just kind of creepy. Also, there's one scene where the house is like infested with moths that are coming from the box, and I get the demon, they're coming from that, and they're just everywhere. And the dad opens the door to her room, and the room is just coated with moths, and she's just kneeling on her bed looking at the box like there's nothing going on. And also, as you know, they showed the scene in the trailer where she's in the bathroom looking in her throat, and the demon's fingers come up in her throat, so that was kind of cool. And now she's slowly becoming the demon. The demon is taking her life for its own. And the dad ends up going to this, like, Amish place. His Amish society, and he brings the box with him, and he asks them, like, "What can I do?" Because the writing, he goes to a scientist or guy, doctor guy, and he says that the writing on the box is Hebrew. So he ends up going to the Amish Jewish thing, and he asks them, like, "What does this mean? What is happening?" And he's like, "Oh, the demon is taking your daughter's life, and it's gonna become your daughter, like, your daughter doesn't have much time left before she's, like, she's no more." So he throws the box away, and the little girl is just freaking out. She's like, where is it? Sorry, but my microphone, like, cut out. Then they're talking in the hallway. Pretty much the demon and the dad are talking in the hallway because the daughter isn't speaking for herself. And they're talking, and she's yelling at him, like, where the hell did you put my box? And then she starts, like, she, like, throws her head back, and you hear, like, this punch noise. And she starts freaking out, like, Daddy, what are you doing to me? What are you doing? And the daughter is behind them in the hallway. And to her, from her perspective, it looks like the dad just beat his daughter in the face. And the demon does it again. So it looks like the dad's, like, wailing on her. And the girl, the possessed daughter, ends up running all the way to where the dad threw the box out. Because I guess she can, like, sense where it is. So she finds it. And, like, this thing happens in the parking lot, I guess, where all these moths just fly in her mouth. And it was kind of weird. But then the dad loses custody of both of his daughters because they all think that he's beating her because she has bruises on her face, which the demon did, of course. But they both think that the dad hit his daughter. So, yeah, a bunch of stuff happens. The dad goes to his ex-wife's house and he tries to perform an exorcism by himself because he looked up some videos of, like, what to do in a situation like this, and it doesn't work at all. So, God, my microphone is really being a bitch and a half right now, but as I was saying, he doesn't know, like, he tries to do the exorcism, and it doesn't work. And the mom is like, oh, she's fine. She's just, our divorce is just, it's hard on her. But then she realizes that there's something really seriously wrong with her daughter, because in the middle of the night she ends up going out into the kitchen because she hears something, and the daughter's just pigging out in front of the fridge. All this food is on the ground, and she's like, she's eating all of it because she eats for herself and for the demon. Like, there's one scene when they're in a restaurant and she's eating, like, french fries. She's like, can I have some more? She's not done yet, or whatever, like, the demon isn't done yet, or he's still hungry, or whatever she says. So that was kind of weird. But then the daughter being possessed, the mom sees her, like, knocking stuff all over the kitchen, like she's breaking glasses on her feet. And the mom realizes now that, wow, there's something really wrong with my daughter. So they end up taking her to a hospital, and she gets a CAT scan. And this is probably my favorite part of the whole movie. Because when she gets the CAT scan, the picture that they're doing, as it's slowly developing, you start to see the actual demon inside of her. Like, you see its face, and it's moving and stuff, and it looked really cool. And the music that was playing was really eerie, so it was, like, really, really creepy. But they end up taking her to a room in the hospital where she's resting. And the father brought back one of the people from the Amish society to help with an exorcism. So they end up, they have to take her to, like, a isolated area in the hospital. So they take her, like, downstairs, and they lay her on a table, and he lights all these candles and stuff, and he starts doing, like, this chant. And it was really funny because the way he was chanting, he was, like, moving back and forth, like, thrusting his upper body, and it looked really weird, and it was kind of funny. And, but yeah, it's not really working, so the girl's just flipping out. She, like, in one of the trailers, shows her, like, jumping on top of the Amish guy. And then, he ends up doing something, so it goes away. And, oh, no. She leaves the room, and I don't even know what happens. Like, the dad chases her, and they're in the room, and she jumps on top of him, and, like, she's beating him up or something, and then the next scene, she's, like, fine. So they're, like, hugging on the floor. They're all hugging. The Amish guy's like, wait a second, something isn't right here. And then they all, like, get away from the dad, and now the dad has the demon inside of him. So he's, like, flipping out now, and the Amish guy starts chanting again. He's chanting the name of the demon, which is, like, Abizu, And he just starts, keeps screaming that. And then you slowly start to see the demon crawl out of the dad's mouth. And this scene almost gave me a seizure because the lights are flickering on and off, like back and forth really fast. And it was like giving me a headache. But it's a really cool scene because you see, and each time the light comes on, the demon is farther out of his mouth. And it looks like Voldemort before he got put in the cauldron in the fourth Harry Potter movie. Like that little tiny Voldemort. That's what it looks like. And he crawls back into the box, and it's like, it's over. So the Amish guy, like, the family's all back together again. Of course, you'd expect that. It's all fine now. So the Amish guy is taking the box to dispose of it. And then he gets hit by a semi-truck. And at that scene, I just laughed my ass off. Because that was, like, the funniest thing I've ever seen. He's driving, and a truck just hits him with the box in the car. And, like, the scene cuts, and then it goes to the crash site. The car is all mangled up, and it's slowly zooming out. And in, like, the distance, nobody notices it. The box is just on the ground. And you start to hear the demon's voice whispering. And that's how it ends. So it was kind of a cool ending. But it was just so funny, because, like, you kind of expected something to happen like that. The box would get lost again, and then it sets up for someone else to find it and get possessed. So anyway, the movie was a fun time. It was pretty good. Sam Raimi directed it. I think he did a good job. So let me know what you guys think, if you saw it. And I'm going to have to give The Possession 4 out of 5. Because I did like it. I did enjoy it. I thought it was good. The beginning was a little bit boring, but it picked up a lot in the end. So, yeah, that's basically it. Thanks for watching. This is Fugus 101, signing out.